Hey, what is good YouTube? Expose him back with another video. And guys, in this one, I'm gonna be going over how to have an elite win percentage and just give you guys some tips on how to win more games and improve your record. Now, this isn't really gonna be going over like how to get a high overall, more so if you're a competitive player or something, you don't like to lose, then this is kinda more of a video towards you. Or if this is your first time playing 2K, 2K18 is your first game, I'm gonna be giving you guys some tips on how to win more games and just get better at the game in general. So first off, if you wanna win a lot of games, you have to have IQ, not a ton, because this game isn't really IQ based in my opinion, but you need to have some IQ. There's no doubt about that. If you have no IQ, you're gonna lose plenty of games. To get IQ, just play the game a lot. I've been playing 2K for 5 years now or something, and I've been playing IRL basketball my whole life, so that's how I gathered IQ. Some people just naturally have good basketball IQ. And then there's some people, no matter how much they play, they still have no IQ and they never get IQ. I don't know why, don't ask me. Some people play the game all the time, still have no IQ. It baffles me sometimes, but it is what it is. Next up, you have to have a good teammate. Literally 95% of my games I've ran with Dylan or Baby Wilt. The link to his YouTube channel is in the description. And it's not that Dylan's like the best center in the world. He's a really, really good center, don't get me wrong, but I don't run with him because he's like the best at 2K. I run with him, I have a good ass time when playing with him, I have fun. Like, he trolls all the time. He doesn't like play super serious. Like, when you're losing, he'll get a little tight, but he loves to troll. It's just, I have a good time playing with him, so when I'm having fun, I tend to play better. If you guys pick a teammate that you're scared, or not scared, but if you sell, you're afraid to sell because they're gonna spaz at you or something, that's not a teammate you really want to be playing with. You just want to play with somebody that you could play your own play style with, enjoy the game, and just have fun and won't like get bored after one game or something. But just because you're having fun with them doesn't mean you're gonna win games. They also have to have some IQ. You're not gonna be able to carry them to every single win. So your teammate has to have some intelligence. If you're a guard, you have to have a center that can set good screens. If you're a center, you have to have a guard that can shoot and score the ball. They correlate. But guys, if you're new to the game and you're trying to get a good record instantly, it's probably not gonna happen if this is your first 2K. So just try to learn the game, have fun, develop some intelligence for the game. You'll get better over time, and then I guess you could say, but right now just have fun with a friend and grind the game if you want to get nice. But yeah, make sure to go sub to Dylan, that's my homie. We have fun grinding this game together. Well, not really grinding, but like I said, whenever I play, I really play with him. Like, there was this one time I was testing out a new jump shot and I missed like 7 shots in a row one game, and like 5 shots in a row another game. Bro, he don't get mad, he'll just start laughing, bro. It's funny, but he's a good ass teammate, so make sure you go sub to him. Next, you gotta know your build. If you're a sharpshooter, shoot the ball. That's what you made the build for, so you gotta be able to score the ball. I recommend playing threes if you're a sharpshooter. Sharpshooters get Hall of Fame Limitless, Catch and Shoot, Deep Range Deadeye, and then Corner Specialist, I think. But guys, this year, Hall of Fame Limitless is so OP. You could just pull up from beyond half court. It's even like more OP than last year. So use that to your advantage. Make sure to, if you're running threes and you're a pure sharp, your center could set you off balls, and you just have to get a little bit of room, and then you could just catch it and pull it, and there's really a good chance of it going in with those three Hall of Fame badges kicking in. So if you're new to 2K18, I recommend you make a pure sharp. It literally takes no skill, really. And speed boosting isn't even all that this year, so definitely go with the pure sharp if you're just playing for a record. You could play twos with the pure sharp. They get good off the dribble stats too. And you could still pull from deep in twos, so it's either or with that build, but I recommend sticking to the threes with that one. Now, if you're like a shot creator or a play creator, I recommend just staying on the twos. You get a high ass mid-range and you get gold or Hall of Fame difficult shots. So that's what the shot creators made for, those fadeaway middies. It's so easy to get open for mid-range this year. You just fade, and if you have that gold or Hall of Fame difficult shots, it's gonna be green every time. So with that build, you're not gonna be shooting threes as much. If I was you, I'd stick to playing twos and just get the record up that way. And guys, a lot of people, not a lot of people, but some people say I court hop, and that's not true. If people are on Gotnext, I'll just stay on. I don't care what overall they are, I'll just stay on and play them. But if I just won a game and there's nobody on Gotnext and I'm gonna have to wait 30 minutes to get a game, best believe I'm gonna hop off the court and then go to another threes court. I'm not gonna sit there and wait 30 minutes to get a game. People want to call that court hopping. Doesn't make sense. People really said that that's court hopping, but that's just, I'm not waiting 30 minutes to get a game, so I just go to wherever there's a game. But back to what I was saying, shot creator, play creator, stick to twos, use your badges. Those are really easy wins. I'm a play sharp, so I just play twos or threes. It doesn't matter, I switch it up. Cause with the play sharp, you kind of get like the best of both worlds. So it's like on threes, I could hit the three, and on twos, I could fade away a little bit. So yeah, the one game I did lose was a 2v2. I'm probably like 25-1 on 2v2s and 50-0 on threes. I'm not quite sure like what my split is, but I've definitely played more threes than twos. Twos is definitely more fluky, and threes, usually the better team will always win. And on threes, you could do more like wraps off ball, and it's more team oriented, I guess. The more people that are on the court, there's always going to be more IQ needed. It's just a simple fact, because spacing needs to be better. That's why Pro-Am is like, it's an IQ mode. You need IQ to play Pro-Am. Next up, communication. You and your team need to communicate. You need to know how you're going to play the screens, how you're going to guard them. If they ISO, is the other guy going to crash? All that simple stuff, but you just need to know what your teammate's going to be doing. And once you guys get to know each other and each other's play styles, you're not really going to even need to communicate. It's just going to be like secondhand knowledge, especially on 2v2s. It's one person, so... So, like, when I play with Will, we literally don't even talk about the game, really. So, it's not that serious. I don't even try that hard. This game just, it's an easy game, in my opinion. I'm not going to sweat over the game. It's just, I find the game easy. That's why my record's good. And then, last but not least, if you're a guard or a center and you're going to be shooting the ball, you need to find a good jump shot that is right for you. My last video hit 200 likes, and I think my video before that hit 230 or something. So I'm gonna be releasing my jump shot soon, but you guys could always find your own customs and stuff by going to the jump shot creator, and then you could try them out in the limitless range drill in the practice facility. That's how I test all my jump shots to see if they're good. If I green a lot in that, they usually tend to work really well in the park, and that's how I go about testing my jump shots. But if you guys can't make a jump shot, all this stuff that I told you before is useless. You need to be able to score the ball and hit your jump shot. Once you find a good jump shot, you just need to learn that jump shot. But a lot of people dribble just to dribble in just 2K in general, and it's not really necessary. I just play to score. I don't really do what's more than necessary, so I'll just get open, shoot it. I don't have to sit there and spam a move for 20 minutes. I'm just trying to get games over quickly. If you guys are trying to go for overall, definitely watch a different video. This is more how to get an elite win percentage and become more of an elite player, a complete player. I have credibility, I guess you could say, in this aspect. Definitely, I have like a 99 win percentage or a 98 win percentage this year. Definitely should not even lost the game I lost. Then last year I had a 90 plus win percentage. So I know how to win games. I'm not the best dribbler. I was never the best dribbler. But I know how to score. I know how to play defense. And it's just simple stuff in the game that you need to know how to do. But definitely it's not a solo game. You need to have good teammates. That's the main thing. You need to have two people, three people that know what they're doing, know how to switch on screens. They just need to have simple IQ. This game doesn't take much IQ, so they just need to have a little IQ, and you should be set. Should start winning more games. But that's all, YouTube. Make sure to leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe. Peace, YouTube.
police pull me over, they ain't got nothing to say. I told them I got tents because I'm rich, they said okay. Gotta pray a lot, niggas get shot up every day. Heard you got a big body but a little face. Got a 41 bezel with a 100K.